points away, it'll be the Minnesota Lynx going up against the Chicago Sky. Along with Tim Swartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Ciniga, and we're happy to have you along for another great game. And it's the Lynx to start out. Now McBride. Here's Dangerfield. Here's Fouls. And it's good off the glass.
Because of her physical presence down low, Fouls remains a dependable interior scoring option.
Outside, Parker. Shot clock at five. Back to Vandersloot. No good from outside. And here are the Lynx now. Pass to Dangerfield. McBride outside. And two free throws coming up as she misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. That one on Quigley.
Selected third overall in the 2014 WNBA draft, McBride's stats and all-star selections pretty much justify where she was picked.
And the first one drops. On the second, so she makes both. Here's Chicago now. A 4-point game. Outside to Shields. Pass to Vandersloot. Six on the shot clock. Dolson misses from short range. Outside, Powers. Down low. The shot, no good. The Sky go the other way with it. Here's the Shields. First shot, first basket. She is out of the block fast.
By speed and a never back down attitude, the Shields is able to not only drive, but hit those tough shots.
And down it goes, 2 points.
That rebound and the follow, it shows you what she's all about. Gritty, determined, and a soft touch to match.
Now here's Vandersloot. Doesn't get it to drop for her. Some solid defense from Damiris Dantas. Pass to McBride. Now Dangerfield. Vandersloot defending. Fouls. Good work defensively by Stephanie Dolson. Chicago trailing here. Left side, Quigley. Now here is Dolson. Up top to Shields. Shoots from the elbow. Rebounded by McBride.
The shots aren't dropping yet. They've missed four of their first five shots.
It's good.
Beautifully crafted for maximum efficiency. McBride's a natural playmaker.
Vandersloot outside. Now here's Quigley. McBride covering. Dolson up top. And there's the 3-second violation. And here in the first quarter, a little over 3.5 minutes played. Pass to Fouls. Dangerfield. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it seems like it's come from inside the paint. Buckle up on defense.
Yeah, it's time to collapse down and make them shoot jumpers.
Now here's Parker. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game. Count it.
What a tough-minded competitor Candace Parker is. She embraces the challenge of converting through contact.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight.
Parker was the first player to win the WNBA MVP award and the Rookie of the Year award in the same season. I mean, what a special talent.
Now here's McBride. That's her second shot and her second basket. My math says that's 2 for 2.
They've been hot here early, dropping them in left and right.
Yeah, we'll see how long they can keep it going. Arguably the best passer in today's game. Vandersloot really excels at finding her teammates when they're wide open.
Fouls with it, working on Dolson. Shot clock at 6. Here's Powers. Off target from outside. And so it's Chicago with it, trailing by 5. The Shields can't hit.
She had all the time to get that shot off.
Knocks it loose. Outside Powers. Pass to McBride. Allie quickly with the steal. Courtney Vandersloot for 3. Drills it from outside.
Oh, she put loads of work into her shot. Remember, Vandersloot was under 30% from 3 her rookie year. Now she's close to 40% each season.
Minnesota calls a timeout. Chicago on D. Pass to Banham. Shoots over Boyd. And again, no good by Minnesota. Little outside. Copper. Endor.
And she hits it to tie up the game.
Very high quality shot. Can't get enough of those.
Pass to Carlton. Over to the wing. Just 5 to shoot. There's the 3. And the Lynx miss again. And here we go. The sky fast break. Here's Copper. Here's Stevens. And good work on the boards. And they pick up the second chance points.
I admire how Stevens relentlessly crashes the boards. It's pretty special for a young player.
Here's Carlton. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Chanwa, she's guarded by Stevens.
Azaray Stevens with the block.
Because of Stevens' competitive drive, she doesn't want to allow any easy buckets.
Inside.
Shot to stop the run.
It's a Chanwa. And 2 shots coming up at the line as she gets fouled on the shot. And that's going to be a foul on Chicago. And she's got her first free throws of the night right here. And she knocks down the first one.
Born and raised in Canada, it's great to see players like Achanwa continue to make basketball a global game.
And so she hits both. Here's Copper. pass to Boyd. Outside Stevens. And here's Copper. To the middle. Six to shoot. And the Lynx pushing it up now. Here's Shepard. And again, no good by Minnesota. Pass to Copper. The shot's good.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. Just phenomenal ball movement.
Everyone's looking for the best shot, and it's paid off during this run.
Now here's Achanwa. Here's Banham. Rebounded by Copper. Chicago in the lead. Outside Boyd. The floater. And it's Alexander with the rebound.
Those chances, usually they're 2 points for her. The D, I guess, did just enough to bother her.
Shepard. Rebound Chicago. Pass to Endor.
Didn't come away with points, but they'd be happy if every possession ended with that shot.
Here's Carlton. And here's Shepard. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Puts up a three. Banham, no good.
Yeah, she's been off her game this quarter. Just hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go down.
Pass to Copper. Got a hand on it.
Well, that's why opponents fear Shepard. Her combination of length and athleticism makes her a solid shot blocker.
It's a 4 second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Achanwa can't get it to go. And at the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Sky out in front. They lead by two. And we'll bring you the start of quarter two when we return. I got a lot of chips. Always had a pocket. And when you consider how the Sky are doing, guys, what are your thoughts?
What a tough D by them so far. It's been a difference maker.
Nothing has gone uncontested for the most part. And look, that's why they've had success.
Now Copper. Endor, unable to get that one to go. And Minnesota the other way now. Here's Shepard. And they're unable to get the tying basket there. Little outside. Pass to Copper. Chicago again missing. Minnesota trailing. Here's Alexander.
Well, the defense looking to protect the loss there.
Something you struggled with in your career, Tim, but definitely saved the layup with that foul. She's going to have to earn him at the line.
And this is her first free throw of the game. The first one falls. And it's tied up with that one. Now here's Parker. Outside to Shields. Pass to Copper. And here's Boyd. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it. It's good.
Does he usually force shots or over dribble? Boyd plays control, and it's part of why she succeeds on the catch and shoot.
Now here's McBride. She's got six.
Well, I'm going to say the defense got pretty lucky right there, because she's going to make a lot more of those than she misses when she gets that much room.
Here's Boyd. Clock at six. Pass to Copper. Now here's Dolson. Got it off in time to beat the shot clock, but it's no good. And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter here. Carlton gets the bucket. Here's Chicago now. Pass to Parker. To Shields. Now here's Boyd. McBride covering. Here's Dolson. Down to five on the shot clock. Yep, count it.
It's really a sign of a great player. Doesn't let a bump here, contact there. Stopper, nice job by Dolson.
Now Dangerfield. Pass to Carlton. From deep three-point range, but they get it back. The second chance effort. The shot misses. The Sky go the other way with it. Diamond to Shields from outside. Here's Parker. That's it. He's now 3 for 3 and looking sharp.
Well, this is just what Parker brings to the table. It's a passion and it's a commitment to rebounding the rock.
Time called here. The Lynx decide to talk it over.
Yeah, I think the coach is watching a lot of shots they normally make rimming out, and it has to be frustrating. Maybe see if they could create some scoring opportunities at the free throw line.
That may be the answer for them, but you know, ultimately, I expect them to shoot their way out of this slump.
Making some changes here. Here's Fouls. Up top, Dantas. McBride. Pass to Dangerfield. Watches it. A rebound by DeShields. Chicago leading. Here's Parker. And it's good. Fought through the contact. Hit the shot. And she'll go to the line.
Good. Shooting one.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played. Pass to Dangerfield. Five on the clock. Back to McBride.
To halt the run.
And it's good on the lay-in.
Puts everything on the court. Now, McBride will risk her body and mind every day for the good of her team.
Now, here is Dolson. Pass to Vandersloot, to the wing on the left. The Lynx trailing. Here's Dangerfield. And here's Dantas, guarded by Dolson. Now Fouls. And a foul on the shot. She'll go to the stripe for two. It's going to go on Courtney Vandersloot.
Yeah, a player who seemingly welcomes contact. Fouls is physical and earns herself a trip to the line.
And the first one at the line is good.
Everybody knows about Sevilla Fowles' defensive reputation. She's also led the WNBA multiple times in defensive rating. But you look at her offense, she's also paced the league in true shooting percentage.
And she makes both free throws.
Getting to the line and hitting your free throws, it's a good way to get back into a game. It stops the clock, and it extends the game, and they're doing that. They've been perfect from the line so far here in the second quarter. When they've gone to her, she's come through. Keep getting her touches.
Pass to Dontas. Outside Powers. Back to Dontas. McBride. Free throw line jumper. They get it again. No good that time. Vandersloot with it. Outside Parker. Let's the floater go. The shot is good. Allie Quigley making the play.
They're finding lanes to the hoop every time down.
Five
buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Or at least some fight.
Time called here. The Lynx decide to talk it over.
Really, they're not pleased at all with the look they've given up inside, and they want to talk to the team about tightening things up defensively.
Well, that's what's got to happen, and I'm sure the coaches will let them know about it. I mean, they're playing some soft interior defense, and that's a recipe for disaster.
Bantam. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Here's McBride. Score the basket. Her fourth, and she's only missed one of her five shots tonight.
The catalyst of the team, McBride is dependent on for buckets, and I'll tell you, she usually delivers.
Here's Endor. Now Quigley. Shot clock at six. The fadeaway. Bantam with the rebound. To the inside. Powers. And she uses the glass on the layup.
Understanding defense is better than most. McBride's a playmaker with an advanced feel for the game.
Now here's Quigley. To Endor, and here is Vandersloot. Lays it up and banks it in.
Even against tough interior defense, Vandersloot still makes it work. She never gives up when she's out there.
Now here's Powers. Here's Bantam. Misses the three.
She has slipped into a real funk here.
Definitely. The basket is not looking very big to her at this point.
Here's Quigley. It's a five-point game. That's tipped. Pass to Parker. Now Vandersloot. That's good, and it's Candace Parker with the assist.
Well, this part of the court, Vandersloot loves it. She isn't afraid to put it in from the mid-range.
Now here's McBride. She's covered closely. It's in, and she's a very efficient 5-for-6 on the game. Timeout called the Sky. Vandersloot.
7 points in the game.
Outside Quigley. Pass to Stevens. 5 to shoot. Here's Endor. That one falls.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Every pass is with purpose, and their last 10 points have come off of assists. Great team basketball on display right now.
Here's Shepard. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Dontis's shot is off. Chicago leading. Allie Quigley drives in. Courtney Vandersloot for three. Missed it. Shooting 50% at 3 for 6.
They really want to find that igniter here.
That's right. Their offense is ground to a standstill.
Maybe you need to suit up, Tim. They need a spark.
And she was fouled in the act of shooting. An opportunity for a 3-point play.
You know, she didn't make it to the line in that entire first quarter, but she is showing some aggressiveness here.
Now here's Quigley. Endor. And it's rebounded by Sylvia Fowles. Here's Shepard. Guarded by Quigley. Pass to Shepard. Shoots over Quigley, and the shot no good, a bit short.
She had all the space she needed, but just could not find the bottom of the bucket.
She's been ice cold, unable to contribute offensively.
Carlton gets the bucket. Here's Boyd, and no good trying to get that one. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. The Sky up 2, and we'll return shortly. Can you say, Parker, just an impressive effort here today?
Well, she created a lot of good shots for herself in the first couple of quarters, and she knows when to pass up on the tough one. Good shot selection.
And that led to a very high points per shot number for her, and that's a stat that really tells you how efficient a player has been.
Now here's Quigley, looking for her first basket still in this one. Vandersloot outside.
Hey, eyes up, watch her. Don't give her space.
Just 5 on the clock from past the arc, and Stephanie Dolson hits from deep.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket for a terrific assist. You know, they've done a lot of that today.
And you know, it's something we haven't seen much at the opposite end of the court.
Here's Dangerfield. Fouls, that's good.
What power from Fouls there. Embraces the contact and still figures out how to score.
Vandersloot outside. From the arc. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Right outside. Here's Dangerfield. Another one falls for Minnesota.
perfect screen there. Set her up with a terrific look.
Yeah, but that's a bad job by the defender to not fight through that screen to contest.
You want to see more effort there.
Quigley.
Bucket is good.
Strong float game from Quigley, and that's what separates her from other players labeled as shooters. She can hit hard shots like that.
Here's Dangerfield.
Pass to Powers. That shot off the mark. Some solid defense from Diamond to Shields. Fires for three. And it's rebounded by Sylvia Fowles.
They're 3 of 4 to start the second half.
To the paint. The shot's good. Kayla McBride making the play.
Never one to shy away from contact. What concentration from Fowles to get the bucket.
Diamond to Shields from outside. It's hauled in by the Lynx. And the Lynx pushing it up now. Pass to Fowles. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
Everything going to plan to start the third. 80% shooting thus far.
Courtney Vandersloot attacking.
Quigley.
McBride covering. Here's Dolson. And she lays it straight in.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss her.
Minnesota calls a timeout. Teams will make substitutions.
Here's Dangerfield.
Vandersloot defending. And that one good.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area, just dominating down low.
And obviously, that's something the defense has to address.
Now here's the Shields. Just 5 to shoot. Count the basket.
Attacks contact with confidence.
The Shields is pretty much always looking to one-up her opponent.
Here's Dangerfield. And Stephanie Dolson with the block. Had a nice open look right there.
That's just a defensive breakdown. I mean, she is not the player you want to leave open from the perimeter.
Pass to Vandersloot. Here's Copper. Down low. And the bucket counts, and she's on her way to the line to try to make it a three-point play.
Well, Vandersloot's coaches have to appreciate the confidence she instills in her teammates. She's a playmaker in just about every sense of the word.
Here's Dangerfield.
Here's Shepard. And it's Dolson with the rebound.
Well, she didn't have a hand in her face, so I thought she was for sure going to bury that.
Offensive rebound. And they're going to count the bucket and send her to the line. It could be a three-point play. And that one misses.
2017 was a breakout year for Stephanie Dolson. She shot 56% from the field, 44% from three-point land and averaged almost 15 per game, making her second All-Star team.
Now here's Boyd. Pass to DeShields. Now here's Boyd. And so it looks like the Sky will retain possession here. To the inside. Here's the Shields. The shot, no good. The Lynx go the other way with it.
She's gonna play her way right onto the bench if she continues to shoot the ball like she has this quarter.
Got a piece of it. Achanwa drops in the layup for two.
Through her first 5 years in the league, not one three-point attempt. Achanwa is a throwback power forward. She's gonna pound you inside.
Now here is Stevens. To Coffer. Endor. Fade away. Shepard pulls it in. For the tie. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. That one's on Stevens.
Aggressive, attacking. I applaud Shepard for putting the ball on the floor and the pressure on the defense.
First one falls for her.
A great scorer and rebounder in college. I can't wait to see Shepard do that in the WNBA for years and years.
That one drops. She ties it up. One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough to defend.
For the lead. A rebound by the Sky. A drive by Diamond DeShields. That one goes. Count it.
Well, if you want to slow down DeShields, you can never allow her to take it to the hoop. Diamond is just so quick and can finish at the rack.
To the middle. Here's fouls. Add another one in the scoring column for her. She's 7-for-10 from the field.
Offensively, a perfect quarter. She hasn't missed a single shot.
Outside Boyd. Here's Stevens. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the line.
Well, no task is too tall for Stevens because she'll fight through contact all day if she has to.
First trip to the free throw line for her tonight.
Yeah, selected to the WNBA All-Rookie Team after an impressive first year. I would say Stevens has a bright future ahead of her, wouldn't you say?
Now here's Achanwa. Pass to Shepard. Dangerfield. Boyd covering. Boyd on the double team. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession, so we'll have a jump ball. And so it's Chicago with it. Chicago in the lead. And here's Copper. Here's Endor. Six on the shot clock. Pass to Copper. And it's rebounded by Sylvia Fowles.
Great look. Disappointing miss.
What happened there? I mean, that shot's almost as good as automatic.
I don't know.
She always knows where her teammates are going to be, and she'll have that ball there waiting for them.
Timeout call to Sky. with it. To the right side. And here's Copper. Basket good.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it did not work. Not if it results in that shot.
Pass to Dangerfield. Here's Shepard. No good from the wing.
She has lost all confidence out there. Still not a single field goal made in the game. They're just killing them in the paint.
You can say that again. I mean, the defenders aren't being nearly aggressive enough down low.
They're just killing them in the paint.
Thank you.
Here's Dangerfield. Here's Carlton. From outside, off the mark.
Even without that three ball dropping for her, the defense should have done way more on that last play.
Yeah, I mean, the D's got to be better as a coach. You can't stand seeing her having that much space to get her shot off.
California native, Boyd didn't even have to leave the state to play collegiate basketball. That must have felt good.
Here's Dangerfield. Over to the left wing. Here's Achanwa. And the layup's good off the glass.
A nice conclusion to a good-looking possession. Coach has got to be happy about that one.
Pass to Dolson. Quigley. To Dolson. Six to shoot. Here's Copper. Chicago again missing.
The spin freed her up, but she just couldn't follow through with the shot.
Here's Carlton. And you can count it. She'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Where was the box out? Some easy second chance points.
Those kinds of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
Vandersloot. She's got 13. And a miss. And we have just finished the third quarter and a tight game we've got. It's the Sky. They lead by three. And time to step away quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. And now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
This was an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for her.
Yeah, she served her up some tasty room service right there, guys. Sweet dime.
We're set to start up the action in the fourth quarter, and if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. Now here's Powers. Inside, fouls, falls right in. She is 8 for 11 with that shot.
Well, there she goes again. Fouls one of the best scoring centers in the WNBA.
Pass to Parker. Copper. The left rim and out.
Well, they're winning despite her errant shooting.
To the paint. Got a piece of it. Looking to get it going. And the layup is up and in.
Look at that move. Is she special or what? I love watching her operate inside.
Pass the fouls. We've played just over a minute here in the fourth quarter. Now Powers. Guarded by Quigley. Clock at four. Powers' shot is off. Right. Right wing. Here's Copper. Again, the miss by Kalia Copper. Right side, Powers.
Pass to Dangerfield.
Here's Dantas. Up and in on the layup.
Gotta put a body on Dantas. When you don't do this, she's more than capable of grabbing offensive boards.
Outside, Quigley. And here's Copper. Another shot. Dolson's shot's good.
That's some tenacity inside, battling for the second chance points.
And they've been struggling here offensively.
Bit of a dry spell for sure.
Pass to Carlton.
Here's Dangerfield.
Vandersloot defending. Shot's good by Dantas.
Great assertive inside play from Dantas. Gets right where she wanted to be and scores.
The kick out to Parker. They get it back. Goes back up. And Dolson with the layup.
She's shaken off her cold shooting performance from the first half.
Pass to Fowles. Now Powers. And she makes that one.
A player that's effective from three-point land. Powers is at home in the paint, pouring that bucket closer in.
And it's rebounded by Sylvia Fowles. The Lynx trailing. Dangerfield, that's good.
This game, it's taken on a new feel since halftime.
Definitely. The energy level on both sides has gone way up after the break, and the energy level in this booth is heating up.
Here's Copper. Pass to Dolson. Out to Vandersloot. Releases. Parker controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Putting on a clinic. You see, once Parker sees the ball go through the hoop, she can catch fire quickly, as she certainly has today.
Here's Carlton. Down low. And that one's good. Foul.
They're beginning to just fall apart defensively, especially on the interior.
Yeah, they're crumbling like a cookie right now, and that's four straight field goals they've allowed from within touching distance of the rim.
Timeout called the sky. You gotta like what Sylvia Fowles has done in this game.
She's been attacking the rim with force. They need to deny her the ball in the paint, keep her away from the bucket.
Chicago trailing here. Now here's Vandersloot. Here's Quigley. Here's Parker. The shot is good. Allie Quigley making the play.
No doubt, Parker's a player who can score from range, but what makes her so deadly, at 6'4", she can just dominate it inside.
Now here's Dantas. Allie Quigley with some nice D. Outside to Shields. They blow the whistle just as she gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the strike. To Shields. Shots good by Fowles.
With strong court vision and awareness, McBride is able to read defenses and find the open teammate.
Now here's Dolson. The jump hook. Some solid defense from Damiris Dantas. Parker with the double team. Pass to Powers. 6 on the shot clock.
Wow, it is a huge day on the glass for a player who's, you know what, they're giving up a lot of size to bigger players out there. Very impressive. The defense pretty much helpless to stop that layup, just too much of a mismatch in terms of height.
Now here's McBride. She's guarded closely. Fades and shoots. Rebound Chicago.
Anyways, that was a nice try to create some space for herself with the fadeaway.
So she gets the whistle, contact on the way up, 2 shots next.
More of a distributor than a scorer, but Vandersloot can still attack defenses in her own right.
Two shots.
She makes the first.
They're drawing more whistles and working their way to the line here in the second half.
And that's the right thing to do with the lead. You want to keep going at defenders and find a way to get to the line.
Get those freebies.
So she gets them both. Here's Minnesota. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Great open look there.
Very steady beyond the arc. Powers is a player that forces defenders to challenge her, to come out, stretches the floor.
Pass to DeShields. Dolson, covered by fouls. Parker, good.
Well, when I think of Candace Parker, the first thing I think of, winner. She loves these moments.
Now Powers, here's fouls, guarded by Dolson. McBride with the ball, here's Powers. The three-pointer, no good.
Just like me, 9 times out of 10, she's going to bury the 3 when she's left all alone like that.
To the inside, the Shields. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball not only inside, but convert those opportunities.
No doubt what their offensive philosophy is today. Pound that ball inside.
I love it.
Minnesota calls a timeout.
They could tell their players were dragging a bit and called timeout to let them catch their breath.
Pass to Dangerfield. There's the double team with DeShields. To the middle. That shot, no good. And Chicago will come the other way. From deep, Allie Quigley. And that comes off the assist by Courtney Vandersloot.
That's just great all around. The passer gets the assist. Quigley gets the points. Good teamwork.
And Vandersloot over to help. And the ball is tied up. So we'll have a jump ball. Chicago with the ball. Sweet little floater.
As a shorter player, you need a floater. Vandersloot has it, and it neutralizes bigger shot blockers in the paint.
Here's Dangerfield. Powers.
And nothing is falling right now for them. And Sylvia fouls with the swat.
McBride with the ball. Picked up by Quigley.
An unpredictable creator with a variety of moves. McBride thrives on getting to the line.
Here's
throw is good. Both shots good from the stripe. And a good chance for them to slow it down.
Yeah, they should use some clock.
Outside to Shields. Outside Quigley. To the paint. And it's Dolson missing. Here's Powers. Hits the three-point bomb.
We just saw the mental aspect of Powers' game. You know, when you have a defender on you and you still make it, nothing rattles.
Timeout called the Sky. Here's Vandersloot. Outside Parker. Shoots over Achanwa. Parker gets the bucket.
That's a phenomenal example of confidence in your shot. Now, it's Parker's belief in herself that allows her to routinely punish defenses.
Even double teams, she had the vision to see the open player.
Pass to Parker. Side to Shields. Now here's Quigley. Four on the clock. Here's Dolson. Tries again. And she lays it in.
Another reason you want Dolson on your team. She can turn a missed basket into points. Tremendous effort on the boards.
Vandersloot with it. Chicago picking up the win.